Changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself, for my wife, for my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Ah, you're probably wondering why my character just moved his mouth for a second and then immediately didn't say anything. I'm using the silent protagonist mod. Yep. Our character is going to be absolutely silent the entire game, which is going to be really nice for me. Never was a fan of the voice protagonist, but man, he does a great narration in that intro. Anyways, I'm gonna be making the character now, so I will see you all on the flip side. Can I say that? Nah, that sounds stupid. I'll see you all when I'm done. Okay, and here we are. Our character, his name is Clark, and as you can tell, Clark has a bit of damage on his face, and that's because I am gonna be rolling with the story that the male character was a war veteran. Now, Clark was part of a sniper unit, so as you can imagine, he's going to be mostly sticking with scoped weapons, trying to keep at a distance, but he will have some other tricks up his sleeve when enemies get close, we'll say. So, we are done with our character creator. And right here, you're going to see another mod I have installed. I do have an alternate start mod installed, but we are not going to be using that. Just going to be doing the normal intro. So, your mind clouds, reality blurs and twists as if breaking apart. Do you awaken from this reality and into another? No, we slumber. Yeah, there we go. So that'll keep the normal intro going. The other option actually takes you to an institute area, and it kind of just lets you create your own world. Okay, I think we've had enough of that. Okay, let's go check out. Sean is sleeping. We're gonna let Sean sleep. Good morning, Cosworth.
173.5 degrees Fahrenheit. Brewed to perfection.
You are very right, Cosworth.
Newspaper just delivered.
Thank you. Yes. Coffee, or morning, sorry. Mornings are for coffee and contemplation. I'm hoping plenty of people get that reference. Okay, so let's see. Can we talk to Cosworth?
Your coffee, sir.
Thank you, Nora.
Wow, look at you! How'd a girl like me ever get so lucky?
Sounds like someone made a sticky. I should attend to young Shaw.
Thank you.
You know, I was nervous at first, but Cosworth's really good with Sean.
Yeah, I wish he could put away the giant spinning blades when he deals with our child, but, you know, you seem to be totally fine with that. We've got Vault-Tec outside our house. Why do we have Vault-Tec outside of our house? I see a tiny hat walking towards our door. Okay, I'm prepared to answer the door. Hello.
Can you get that?
Yep.
It's probably that salesman. He comes for me every day.
Yeah. Where have I been every day to where I've missed him? Anyways.
Good morning. Vault-Tec calling.
And you know, let me real quick make sure that I have... where is it? Dialogue camera set to off. Subtitles on. General subtitles on. Right. Okay. Okay. Yeah, good morning.
Isn't it? Just look at that sky out there. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
Yeah, what exactly is so urgent?
Why, nothing less than your entire future. If you haven't noticed, sir, this country has gone to heck in a handbasket. If you'll excuse my language, the big kaboom is... it's inevitable, I'm afraid. And coming sooner than you may think. If you
quite the optimist.
My meaning. Now, I know you're a busy fellow, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family's service to our country,
you believe this guy, Nora?
Pre-selected for entrance
no, I'm
into
listening.
The local vault. Vault 111.
Yeah, that sounds great, almost too good to be true, to be honest. Yeah, so there's enough space for everybody, correct?
Of course, of course. Minus your robot, naturally. In fact, you're already cleared for entrance. It's just a matter of verifying some information. Don't want there to be any holdups in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. Won't take but a moment.
Yeah, sure.
Splendid. Splendid. Now, let's see.
Boy, his extreme pessimism is concerning. Anyways, I am Clark. Yes, I am. And let's see. My perception is going to be around the midpoint, maybe a little bit up above that. Charisma, not terribly charismatic. My endurance is actually pretty high as well. I'm not very strong, though. I was in the military, so I do have some training with strength. Agility, also pretty high, probably around the same as my strength. Intelligence, I would like intelligence to be higher than 3. I think we'll knock perception down one. We'll knock endurance down one. Yeah, we'll knock endurance down one, raise my intelligence, and I think that looks good.
Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Yep, thank you.
It's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right? Good answer.
I didn't say anything.
Mr. Clark, Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that paternal affection you seem to be so good at.
You heard Codsworth. Go on.
Yep, I can take care of my child. I don't need everybody's permission. I should be able to do this without everyone's permission. Hey, buddy.
How are the two most important men in my life doing? Spin the mobile a bit. He loves that.
Wow, everyone gives me a lot of directions on how to deal with you, Sean. I don't think they trust me. Probably because I don't spin the little spaceships when you want me to, and I end up sitting here talking to myself. Yep, it's probably on me.
Hey, how's my little guy? Much better now, huh? Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Yeah, nothing could possibly go wrong with the weather. Yeah, that sounds like fun.
Codsworth? What's wrong?
Alright, what's Codsworth yammering on about?
Yes, followed by flashes, blinding flashes, sounds of explosions. We're trying to get confirmation.
What?
We seem to have lost contact with our affiliate stations. We do have coming in. That's, confirmed reports, I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania. My God.
Okay, we have got to go. Okay. Yeah, we're going. Codsworth, you stay here and, well, you're a robot, so I think you'll be okay. Nora, you've got Sean. Okay, we're good. We're good and we're going. Okay, it's very convenient. The vault is this close, but I'm not one to complain about it right now, so I think we're good.
That's absurd! I am vault.
Not on the list. You don't get in.
I'm going in. You can't stop me.
Whoa, they are not messing around. I'm in it.
Adult male. Adult female. Okay, go ahead.
Thank
okay,
you.
Nora, we're going.
You two, follow me.
Whoa, wow, Nora, that was a pretty impressive trick.
Everything we can. Now keep moving.
This way.
In the center.
Just right here? This. Okay, okay. Nora? Okay, you're here. Okay, good.
We love you too.
Oh my god.
Yep, send it down. Send it down now, please. Send it down right now. Thank you. Oh my god. Whew. I think we made it.
We did it. We made it. We're okay.
Everyone, not many of us, though.
Step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111. A better future underground.
So we just...
Yes, up the stairs.
I can't believe it. If we left a minute later...
No, no, we'd all be. Don't get caught up thinking about that. You're safe now. Everyone, just head up these stairs and through the door there.
So you're the overseer, huh?
Head inside. Just up the stairs there.
We made it.
Yeah.
Please, head up the stairs.
I don't know if you would consider this making it. We survived, but this looks a bit more like a prison than a sanctuary.
Levels are good.
Welcome home.
Male.
Yeah. That is, I am a male. Thank you for telling me that.
Female and infant.
But just, take a vault. Yes, everyone can see that.
Right over there. Over there. Take a seat.
You guys gonna explain exactly what that is?
One vault suit.
Just step over to the table.
Yeah, looks fine.
You'll need your suits before we can take you further. Each of you take one of these. Your brand new vault suits.
Do you have it in maybe a green? Or something that looks less, like a blueberry? No?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
All right. You got your suit, Nora?
It's down the hallway right there.
This is our new home.
Oh, you're gonna love it here. This is one of our most advanced facilities. Not that the others aren't great, mind you.
We could do without the sales pitch, actually. We did just survive a nuclear holocaust.
Our home. Everything we had.
My mother and father down in D.C.
Sir?
Oh, God, honey.
Oh,
what if they didn't make it?
I know this is a difficult time. But
how long do you think we'll be down here?
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through first.
It's a good fit, don't you think?
Just the checking everyone off the list as they come in.
As well as comfortable.
Thank you for telling me. Right? So you're putting us in this?
Such a lovely family you have. I hope you'll see this as your new home.
Well, it's very cold in here. I'd prefer if we could get some jackets. Blankets.
Just step in here and put your vault suit on.
It'll be okay. Daddy's right here. See?
Hey, buddy.
There he is. See? Daddy's not going far.
All set?
Yeah.
Just step inside and put on your vault suit.
Give me a minute before me and my wife are separated into creepy whatever these are. Freezers?
Go ahead, hun. I'll take Sean with me.
All right, and I need to ask you about
step
this
into
before.
The chamber whenever you're ready.
Yeah, but. All right, here we go.
The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
Resident secure.
Yeah, just relax. Easy, right?
Occupant vitals. Normal. Procedure complete. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Okay.
Almost.
cryogenic array. All the residents must vacate immediately.
Oh my god. That wasn't a dream. She's really gone. Goodbye, Nora. I will find who did this. But I have to get out of here. Okay. Okay. Getting my head on straight. I need to figure out what... Oh, God. Well, I'm gonna have nightmares for years. Stimpak security terminal? Where is everybody? Alright, Vault 111 security instructions. Vault 111 is designed to test the long-term effects of suspended animation on unaware human subjects. Okay. Security staff are responsible for maintaining installation integrity and monitoring science staff activity. Under no circumstances are staff allowed to deviate from assigned duties. Insubordination or interference with vault operations are capital offenses. Security staff are authorized to use lethal force. Are you kidding me? Okay. Operations protocol manual. Resident admittance. Upon activation notice from Vault Tech, all personnel are required to report to the entry area and assist with admittance of vault residents. Security personnel will maintain order and ensure that no personnel or residents attempt to evacuate the vault. Research staff will be responsible for resident intake and escort each to the designated cryogenic pod. Residents not accounted for in the manifest should be asked to step aside and detained forcibly by security if necessary. Once all residents have been sealed into their preservation chambers, dispose of any detainees. Vault entryway must remain sealed under any circumstances. Oh my god. All clear and evacuation. The all clear message. Following a nuclear event, Vault Tech will monitor hazards such as radiation levels, enemy invasion, subsequent attacks, and other factors. Once conditions are deemed safe, this terminal will receive an all clear notice. Upon receiving the all-clear notice, Vault Tech personnel may be evacuated at overseer discretion. Disregard any notices from organizations or individuals not associated with Vault Tech, including government and military. Residents are not to be disrupted or evacuated. Vault Tech will attend to their needs remotely once Vault 111 staff has been evacuated. So we've been sitting in a freeze box for God knows how long, with not even anyone... around? Mandatory shelter period. Vault 111 is classified as a short-term assignment. Non-resident personnel are expected to carry out research duties and basic maintenance of the vault while awaiting the all-clear signal to evacuate. In the absence of an all-clear message from Vault Tech, the overseer may elect to evacuate staff after a mandatory shelter period of 180 days of containment. Under no circumstance may Vault 111 staff evacuate during this shelter period unless receiving the all-clear message from Vault Tech. Okay, security logs. Oh, that's a lot. God, it finally happened. The world's over. Barely got all the residents inside. Not everyone made it. Now it's just us and the icebergs. Thank you for referring to us as icebergs. I don't get it. Eggheads tried to explain to me that keeping them frozen is a big experiment. For a better future or something, I don't know. It just doesn't seem right that we're smiling at them all that time before putting them on ice. Shouldn't we have told them something? Yeah. I mean, yeah, that's the answer. You should have told us everything, to be honest. Okay, that was October 23rd, 2077. That was the day the bombs fell. Next log was December 25th, almost 2 months later. Christmas Underground got together with the rest of the security boys and support staff and had a little party. Best gift that got handed out was a fancy lad snack cake that wasn't too stale. Ugh. None of the scientists came. Overseer wasn't there either. I just don't get them. They hiding something from us? Another company secret only for the higher-ups? Whatever, just a few more months until the all-clear is supposed to come through, then we can start rebuilding. Okay, now we're looking at March 14th, 2078. This is, what, another 4 months or something afterwards? Only a few weeks left in our mandatory shelter period. Everyone's getting stir-crazy. Some people are even saying the all-clear signal is never coming. We can't stay here much longer, that's for sure. It's not just the fact that I've been staring at the same break room and bunk bed for over 6 months. It's the fact that we only have enough food left for another few months. Tops. The Overseer keeps telling everyone to be patient, focus on work. He's definitely keeping us out of the loop. Something bad is going on. I just know it. Alright, second to last entry is April 23rd. The main door accessing the vault exit is malfunctioning. Now the only way out is through the Overseer's evacuation tunnel. How convenient for him. He has one of the science team watching the door into his office at all times from a little makeshift checkpoint. Got invited to a meeting tonight, support staffers and security only. Sounds like I'm not the only one with an axe to grind. Last entry. No all clear from Vault Tech is coming. We need to leave. We're all but out of food. I almost murdered Stanley for dropping a damn salt cracker on the floor. A handful of us confronted the Overseer about opening up the vault. I never knew a man that small could shout that loud. Now he's locked himself in his office along with the rest of the science staff. We're supposed to hand over any food, weapons, and medicine we have by tonight, or there's going to be consequences. I've talked to everyone. It's time. One way or another, we're getting out of this vault. Wow. Okay, well, I'm not seeing anyone around, so at some point, they did manage to get out. Alright. Where the hell was that giant? Ugh! Oh, God, that's disgusting. Ugh. Oh, God. Rad roach meat. I am not picking up anything related to a giant cockroach. I will take beer bottles. Bobby pin, pack of cigarettes, more beer bottles. Alright, what's this say? Overseer memo. Remember, use of the recreational terminal is a privilege. If work performance declines, this privilege may be revoked. Enjoy responsibly. Yes, because they seem to have so much work to do watching us sit in an icebox. Top 10! Okay. We've all done that. We have all done just three letters as our initials. Play tape. Red Menace. No, thank you. Yes. Okay. Let's move on. I have slightly more pressing things to worry about right now than getting the high score on Red Menace. Okay, nothing in here. Nope. Okay. Oh, and that does remind me, real quick. Yes, there we go. path around that. Okay. Got some mad scientist stuff going on in here. And more giant cockroaches. Perfect. Ugh, God. Okay, so I'm avoiding the electricity. Ha! Ah! Oh, God, that one kind of snuck up on me. Avoiding the electricity. Oh. Ooh. That one suffered a pretty unfortunate end. Okay. Oh, God. That did some damage. Nope, I missed. Get him. I'm hitting the other one. I hit the other one. Whew. Okay. Can I drink the water? Oh, fill bottle. I'm going to need water, I assume. It's also been a ridiculously long time since I've had anything to drink. Okay. And there we go. Okay. I'm assuming this is the main entrance here. Stim packs I could use with the health. Eyeglasses, I don't think so. Okay, Overseer's Terminal. Alright, Vault 111 Overseer Instructions. Vault 111 is designed to I've already read that. Cryolator. I've long dreamed of making cryogenic freezing available in a portable, on-demand form. The cryolator is my latest attempt. Thankfully, we're in no short supply of the chemicals and components. I need to tinker with the prototype. It's a nice way to occupy the time as we wait for the all-clear signal. Operations Protocol Manual, I believe I have read. Overseer's Log. Preparations. The final staff orientation is complete. All but a few of the residents down in Sanctuary Hills have been enrolled, and several from Concord as well. Vault Tech supervisors came up this week to do a technical review with me. This vault is ready to open. I can only imagine what wonders our residents will get to witness. No wonders. I'm not in awe of anything. The notion of leaping forward in time. I almost wish I could join them and see the promise of our future realized. Well, then you could have taken my spot. October 23rd. It's happened. We were lucky that most of the staff was nearby when the early warning came through. We had less notice than expected, but only Nordhagen was missing when we sealed the entrance. Resident admittance went smoothly. Everyone made it, even the family that waited until the last minute. I'm assuming that was me. I was worried there would be more suspicion, but things happened so fast for these people, they must have been too overwhelmed to question the cryogenic pods. I questioned them, nobody answered me. Systems malfunction. Strange issue today with pod C3. Subject appeared to be having heart palpitations. Nothing life-threatening, but unusual. We realized almost too late that the pod was malfunctioning. The cryogenic array almost started thawing her out. We're not sure, but I suspect a hiccup in Vault-Tec remote override systems may have sent an errant signal. We'll have to keep an eye out. I only hope their systems are reliable once we evacuate the staff. Supplies running low. Yeah, the staff mentioned that. There's been no all-clear signal yet, even though we're nearing the end of the 180-day mandatory shelter period. Supplies were never intended to last much more than that, and despite my best efforts, people are beginning to question what we're doing down here. If people think we can just leave when the 180 days are up, they're insane. The radioactive exposure would still be potent enough to fry everyone if the vault seals are breached that early. The whole point of the all-clear was to receive additional instructions from the main office. I don't know what to do. I can't open the vault. I can't expect our supplies to last forever. I just have to keep everything under control until the all-clear. Mutiny. A faction led by security personnel have turned on me, demanding they be allowed to leave the vault. Idiots. I will not open the door to be irradiated to death out there. I'm consolidating the remaining supplies, putting the staff on lockdown. We're going to have to start prioritizing who deserves what little food we have left. I've been too damn generous with the rations. If people don't like it, well, that's fewer mouths to feed. Whew, he got pretty selfish there at the end then. Okay, let's open the evacuation tunnel. And I think we're good. Okay. Let's take a look around first, though, make sure. Ah, so that's the cryolator he was talking about. It's a master lock, so it's not like I'm getting in there, that's for sure. And doesn't look like anything around here. Some ammo. Why it's in a locker there, I'm not entirely sure. Another stim pack, perfect. Okay. I think we're getting close to being able... Okay. Let's make sure we're getting this dealt with smoothly. Damn it. Okay, got it. Oh, oh god. Okay, there's more. There's more. Okay. Okay, I think we're good. I think that's all of them. It doesn't help that the dripping water sounds like a rad roach sneaking up on me. Okay, but I think we're good. Oh, good thing I was hidden. And is that it with the rad roaches? Are we done with them? No more, right? Is this where I came out of? I think so. I'm not entirely sure. Okay, so we have some ammo. We have some more ammo. Perfect. A new vault suit. Probably better than the one that's... Whoa! Okay. Whew! Wow. Okay. Well... My reflexes did not take a hit, apparently. Oh. I'm sorry, but that I need that. I need it. I'm sorry. Thank you for keeping it so well protected in the meantime. And I'm sorry I dropped your hand. I don't suppose I could scrub this thing down with a wet wipe or something? Just a little... No? Okay. Okay, Pip-Boy acquired! Very first step is... Let's get our quick save assigned. And settings, holotapes, immersive HUD, and activate. Thank you. Okay. Let's get out of here. I do love that. I wish the game had more of that. What was that sound? Oh, that's bright. Goodbye, Nora. Like I said, whoever did that to you, they'll get what's coming to them. That is for damn sure. I knew I was down there for a while, but I'm getting the feeling it was a little bit longer than I expected.